This looks like a regular servo, but this is actually continuous servo, or sometimes they call it 360 servo. What it means is that, as you saw with the servo, which was going 180 degrees, going back and forth, this can run continuously either in clockwise direction or in counterclockwise direction. And controlling this, there was no code available to control it, so I have written this code, experimented, make sure it works with some discrepancy that it has, and I'm going to show you how you can control this servo motor with this three button. So when you press the clockwise or the right one, it will start rotating clockwise. When you press stop, it stops. When you press counterclockwise, the servo rotates in counterclockwise direction. You can directly press the clockwise so you can rotate to clockwise or counterclockwise, or stop it at any moment. Due to internal circuitry, so the stop command sometimes might not be perfect, and as a result you will see that this is slowly rotating. But it could be due to the quality of this specific servo, or maybe as the time goes by, the internal component gets warmer and this will behave like that. But you can adjust it and find the right value, so it can always be stopped. But it will not be fully stopped, so make sure to consider this. As you can see, it's now vibrating. It's just at the edge of rotating slowly. This servo looks exactly like a regular servo, but here they have some DS04 NFC. This is just a mark for a brand, but usually they look the same, all of them. It has internally, this has metal gear. So it comes with all of these hardware, different type of attachment. These four will go on the shaft, and depending on your application, whatever you want to control, these can be included, and also these screws and these bumper rubbers and all of this. And here is the wiring, which I've drawn using FirtSync. This is a free open source software. You can download it. With some modification, I've done it. This is the servo motor. As my previous lectures, pin 9 have been connected to the input signal. The middle wire, or red one, is connected to 5 volts, and ground have been connected to the ground. And on this side, we have three push buttons. The push buttons have left and right side. The left side, all of them, I have connected them to ground. The left of this have been connected with a wire, jumper wire, up to this point. So this is also connected to this point. All of them are connected using this wire to the ground. And the right pin of each have been connected to different pins. So that for clockwise have been connected to pin 2. For the stop, the right pin have been connected with a gray to pin 3. And the right pin of this counterclockwise have been connected to pin 4. And here for this servo motor, but still we have darker color for the ground. The middle color is for the positive, and the right lighter color on this one was orange, and this one, this is white. So ground have been connected to ground here. The middle one is red. I've put another red here connected to 5 volts. And then the left one is the signal input from Arduino, which have been connected to pin 9. And here for the push buttons, I use the same color that I've used in the wiring diagram. The black on this side have been connected to the ground of Arduino. And if I remove these wires, you will see that I've connected one wire here. The left side of this switch is connected to the left side of this, and from here I have another wire to the left of this, and all of them have been connected using this wire to the ground. And then the three wires that we have will be connected to the right of this button, the right of this button, and the right of this button. So three of them have been connected to pins 2, 3, and 4 in here. Let me explain the code. We start by including the servo.h, the header file, with this line, which I've explained it before. You have to include this, otherwise it will not work. And then using the same class, we create an instance of it. We call it my servo. And then we define pin 9 as a servo pin to connect the servo. And these three pins are used, pin 2, 3, and 4, will be used for clockwise, counterclockwise, and stop. And I call them stop pin, CW pin, CCW pin. These are constant and they will not change. This pin must be pulse width modulation pin, one of those pulse width modulation pins that has this tilde beside the name. But these are just digital pins. And after that, we are defining the values, the three values. This is an integer array of CS servo command. And I have three values with a comma separated. This is 106 is for counterclockwise, 52 is for stop, and 0 is for clockwise. I put them in order. Below this, we have string servo command text. And these are the text that will be displayed on the serial monitor. And then status text, this will remember the current status. And this is a text that will be displayed. Currently it's stopped and it is displayed. These three variables, clockwise button status, counterclockwise button status, and stop button status, will be used internally inside the loop, which we will see soon. Inside the setup, we use a serial monitor to initialize the serial monitor with 9600 baud, and then using pin mode, stop pin, clock, counterclockwise pin, and clockwise pin, we set them as input with a pull-up, so we can use a push button without a resistor, which I've explained it in my previous lectures. After that, we attach the servo using my servo.attach servo pin. This will be pin 9 in our case, to the servo. And then my servo.write is the command that sends command to the servo to either stop or move it. And CS1 is the stop command. CS servo command, if you pay attention here, this is the clockwise and this is the stop. We want at the beginning the servo to be stopped, so we send this command to stop the command, the servo, and also we send the text number 1 to show stop on the screen. Text 0, text 1, text 2. So this will send that text to us. After that, inside the loop, we read the three push button pins, CCW pin, using digital read, and also the same thing for stop pin and CW pin, and we read the status of the pin, which is either high or low, and high will be 1, low will be 0. The result will be stored in this variable which we defined above, and for the stop pin also will be stored in the stop button status and clockwise button status respectively. Then we check if counterclockwise button status is equal low, which means if it has been pushed, then we send this command, servo command 0, and this is a function which I'm going to explain next. It's in the lines below. And then else if stop button status, if that is equal low, which means if the stop button have been pushed, then we send command number 1, and which will send the value of number 1 from the array above. And then if it is clockwise button status low, then we send number 2. And then we print this text continuously to show the current status using this number. This number will pick up the value from the array, the appropriate text that I just mentioned, this text, stop. At the moment it is stopped because status is 1, and if you send 1 to this array, let me delete it so you can understand. If I put here 1, CS text 0, 1. 1 means stop, CS text, so it will print this text for us. And then we wait for 50 milliseconds and the loop continues like that. Now let's check this servo command. Servo command is a function that I've written below. When we pass that 0, 1, and 2, it will come here and become and becomes in integer, a variable, and then we immediately in this line we set the status text, either whatever it is, it will be 0, 1, and 2, and the text will be picked up as clockwise, counterclockwise, or stop for our to be displayed. And then we use the same in to pick up the command, the number, and send the servo to that direction. Then we print this text. Also, we print the text telling us the direction at the moment that is the button is pushed. And also, we will display the value that is sent to the servo. And this is open parenthesis and closing parenthesis to display the value. And here is a demonstration. I'm opening the serial monitor. And let's see also these values. I'm pressing the clockwise. If I push it, you see I'm sending 0. You see here CCW 0. This 0 is sent and it is rotating clockwise. And that text is also changed, telling us that this is rotating clockwise. If I press stop, now this is stopped. And if I press and hold it, you will see the value 58, stop inside the parenthesis, 58, that is a value that's coming from here. And if I press clockwise, you will see I'm holding it, it shows 106, but I release it, still it shows counterclockwise, and that is the value. And the text that we are seeing are these texts that are displayed in here. So I just press stop, clockwise. If I hold it, you'll see the value. I did that so you can debug and fine-tune your servo. Otherwise, it's not necessary to be displayed. And using these values, you can change the speed of the servo motor. For example, if I set this to 70 and upload it, whenever you press the counterclockwise command, this will go slower. Now let's see, because that is the angle value. Currently it's stopped. So if I go this, now you see it's rotating very slowly, and if I hold it, you'll see the value is 70. And stop, right, 0 is that the maximum speed. And let's see if I set this to 170, what happens. This is the angle value. I'm uploading the code now, and we will wait. So initially it's supposed to be stopped with a little rotation because 58. Now if I want to, first let's fix this. So now let's reduce this to 54. And as the code is uploaded fully, you will see that this will either stop or rotate to the right. So 54 is almost stopping it, so I can fully stop it by maybe making it 51, three more numbers, or maybe 52. From 54, I reduced it to 52, and let's see. Now it's fully stopped, but still it will change. Now let's press this with 170 and see what happens. That is the maximum speed, and it will not increase the speed. So for us, the value was for around 100, and let me see what was the value, 106. And this value also, the same way, will not affect significantly, but it will make difference, and that's the maximum speed that you can get. This was introduction to the continuous or 360 servo. Thank you for watching.